In this video, I'm going to share with you my 7 top tips to get rid of an anal fissure. By the way, make sure to watch the very end because the last few tips you're never told about. Now, an anal fissure is basically a small tear in the skin lining the anus, and they can be incredibly painful. Now, let's begin with those tips. So let's begin with tip number 1, hold off the toilet paper. I know it sounds controversial, but this toilet paper, it makes it a battleground in the bottom area. All that rubbing makes it almost impossible for the anal fissures to actually recover. Because I'm telling you, it's almost impossible to be gentle when using toilet paper to clean your bottom. That rubbing action is causing micro tears in the anal tissue, which is delicate, and it's also then causing bleeding and discomfort. So moving on to tip number 2, to speed up recovery, I genuinely cannot recommend a water bidet enough. It's like a spa for your behind, okay? It's gentle and it doesn't cause those micro tears caused by these. And once you've washed the area, gently pat the area dry, either with a towel or you can't even use toilet paper, just gently pat the area dry and do not rub. This is the number 1 change that you need to make in order for our anal fissures to recover. Moving straight on to tip number 3, treating underlying issues. If you have constipation or diarrhea, you need to sort them out, okay? Otherwise, it's gonna be nearly impossible to recover from anal fissures. So speak to your healthcare professional about it if it's ongoing for a long time. Also, increase your water uptake, increase your fiber uptake, make those stools easier to pass, which is gonna help. And linking this to tip 4, increasing your fiber uptake. By doing this, the stools are gonna retain more water, so you're also gonna increase your water uptake and make them softer and easier to pass without straining, which is obviously gonna cause problems with the anal fissure. The less we have to strain, the easier it is for us to recover, okay? So have more fruit, more veg, more nuts, more whole grains, all of these are fantastic. So moving on to tip number 5, soothing creams, okay? Look out for creams that contain the following ingredients like glycerin, calamine, kaolin, menthol, zinc oxide. All of these are really useful at reducing the itching and creating a barrier. And these creams also have a moisturizing element to them, so regular applications after bowel movements can really help. It's also gonna help with that skin barrier as well to help protect it and help with recovery. So next up, let me tell you about Pranicura and their FDA registered over-the-counter topical cream for hemorrhoids, anal fissures and severe anal itching. They are very good friends of the channel and they've patented a unique steroid-free formulation that's safe and made in the USA. I will leave a link to them in the description below. Definitely do check them out and their impressive reviews. Pranicura, thank you for being a sponsor of our channel. And moving straight on to tip number 6, stool softeners. These can be very helpful at doing what it says in the title, softening your stools, so you're not having to strain as much, and this is all gonna help with reducing anal fissures and helping with recovery. If you want more information on different options available for constipation and hard stools, it's gonna make this video very long, but I have a video already on it, which I will leave in the description below and is available on my channel too. And diving straight into tip number 7, caution with wet wipes, okay? I 100% recommend them over toilet paper, but again, do not rub excessively. Be very gentle when you're using them, but obviously the preferred option is a water bidet 100% of the time, if you can. And if you do use wet wipes, do not use the ones that have the harsh chemicals in them. Only go for the water-based ones, okay? This is, again, gonna help with that healing. I really hope you find this information helpful. Please remember, with anal fissures, there are a lot of times where you do need to speak to a healthcare professional about them. I will leave loads more information in the description below. As always, sending awesome vibes.